Okay, so I want to make this video to kind of vent about how things have been going since I got fired from Walmart. This is basically the addendum to my original rant that I posted in March, but I made that video going over my 7 months wasted with Walmart, where I was rescued from my minimum wage sweatshop deli job with double hourly pay and a set schedule, only for them to snatch that out of my hand simply because they could. And what I mean by that is they started scheduling me for days that weren't part of my set schedule and not fucking telling me. They gave me a no-call no-show because I couldn't make it in because I was plowed in from snow when I already applied my protected time off. And they started moving my days around, and all that did was confuse me. So I'm making this in May, but I'm gonna save it for that 4 month mark. June 17th. If things change in that time, I'll be sure to add a segment or edit things out versus what I originally say, whether things get better or worse. So this rant is basically just a test of how incompetent and slow my state is to help me out in my time of need. So before the start of the month, I mentioned that I wanted to do this video because I wanted to let you guys in on the world of stress and depression that Walmart has dealt me simply by firing me. All because they couldn't work with me and take the time to tell me, hey, your schedule has changed. We're gonna need you this day this week. Can you make it in? They gave me no choice, and the set schedule they gave me on day one was them lying straight to my face. And because I didn't show up twice for days that weren't part of my set schedule, and they basically fucked me out of my protected time off because I didn't properly call off during the snowstorm, I'm now in this situation. I have not seen a cent of income in 4 months because, one, our Department of Labor and Office of Appeals is incapable of delivering timely responses, and two, I can't fucking find a job. Like, I know that's the first thing on people's minds when they're watching the first minute of this video, but here's what jobs look like in my town. So now you see how barren the job market is here. Those who have been watching my content for a few years now likely know that I live in Kansas. And to clarify, I live just a couple miles north of the border with Oklahoma. I've tried looking for jobs in Oklahoma. I've tried looking for jobs in other towns in Kansas that are within a reasonable driving distance. There's nothing here. There's one town I looked where it was all CDL truck driver jobs. Like, yeah, that's exactly what I want. A job with a bunch of greasy rednecks for co-workers and a boomer shithead for a boss. Beyond what I've shown you guys, my town is mostly just team lead, supervisor, manager positions for retail. And I'm just not qualified to do that, I don't think. I think it's expected that you have at least 5 years of retail experience, and I have a grand total of maybe 3. Plus, I don't think I could handle the stress. Working 12 hours a day, 6 days a week, no social life, no free time, is the kind of job you would do if you devoted your life to the business. And also, if there's one way to get stuck working somewhere forever, it's moving up in the company. That's a principle I take from Eric from Fantavision. I would also hate to be seen as the type of domineering asshole that most people associate bosses with. Okay, so I have my bases covered. There aren't any jobs here, and the jobs that are here have one of four problems. Either they don't pay shit, I'm not qualified for them, their application just results in me signing up for some stupid alert, or they don't read the applications that are sent to them. Like, I don't know if I've told you guys, I've tried applying for Sonic 3 times for their cook position, so I can get their $12 an hour pay, but I never hear anything back. And that's basically the state of my job search. Despair in every direction. My applications are either a waste of time, or I'd be refused the job simply because I don't meet their qualifications. And unfortunately, people treat me like an idiot because I can't find a fucking job because of these reasons. As if I wasn't already being treated like an idiot because I always end up working some shitty retail job, because there's nothing here that would actually help me grow as a member of society, and teach me a skill, or inspire me to pursue something more akin to a career. I just imagine everyone here forcing themselves to show up to work every day for decades until they're old and decrepit, and still continuing to work because social security and health insurance is fucking garbage. It's impossible to save up for anything, let alone retirement, and everyone here hates their lives, and it shows. Everyone here is dead on the inside, and I worry that I'm coming to the same state of mind. And I worry that I have failed at life because I'm 22, jobless, and can't even find a fucking side hustle. I feel like this is what it's like to be under siege. We have held out for months, hoping for relief. Our fortress now our tomb, and salvation now our grief. Those are lyrics from the Amon Amarth song Under Siege, and it really reflects what I'm going through. And it's all because of the DOL here. They drag their feet, they put workers that have been ejected from their job on the back burner, and take so fucking long to help them, and all they care about is the company's side of the story as to why they fired that employee. They don't give a fuck about the working class. In fact, they probably get entertainment in watching us starve. And that brings me to my particular story with the Kansas DOL. And maybe other people from Kansas don't have this problem, maybe in Topeka it's better, but for the small town I live in, it's completely unforgivable. This is based on what I have had to deal with, and I think that in places where you would expect things to be worse, they're actually better than Kansas. I'm not the only person that I know of that is having problems with government assistance here, and I'll speak on that too. Basically, when I got fired, I immediately settled with the fact that I would need to try, at least, to apply for unemployment benefits. But in doing so, I feared that I would need to deal with the government treating needy working class citizens like a bother, because that's exactly what they do. Whether it's because they're trying way too hard to not be seen as socialists, which, fucking pick one, is socialism when free money or socialism when no food? But the government acts so bothered to help the people it governs, especially in capitalist nations such as the US. Either because they're trying way too hard to not look like socialists, or because they think everyone on government assistance are just drug addicts trying to milk the system, despite it probably not being that big of an issue in reality. I'm sure the capitalist administration loves to propagate that point, simply because it might put a dent in their bottom line. But anyways, I applied for unemployment benefits the day after I got fired. Over the next couple weeks, I got a paper in the mail to fill out, and towards the beginning of March, I got a paper telling me my phone call interview date, which was supposed to be the 14th of March. So that already is like almost a month after I got fired, and almost a month after I fucking applied for benefits. But I waited 2 weeks, and on the fucking day of the interview, the people called me, and my phone fucking went straight to voicemail because my spam filter rejected their call automatically. I disabled my phone's spam filter. I tried to call back, but there was nothing I could do to reach the person I was supposed to speak with. They said they were going to make a determination based on the information that they have, and it was maybe a couple days later that I got a letter in the mail telling me that my claim was rejected. So I filed an appeal. I sent both an email and a letter to them, and I had until the 31st of March to file my appeal. And April 1st came, and I hadn't heard anything back. Not a letter giving me a new interview date, no callback, nothing. It depressed me because, as workers, we have been busting more than just our asses for the past 2 years through COVID as essential workers. They propagated us as heroes. We pressed on through an economic crash and inflation, rising gas prices because Biden doesn't actually give a shit about green energy. His administration doesn't really care enough to put us on track to reduce our carbon footprint. And also because of the conflict in Ukraine. And this is how we're repaid. The minute we get fired, our lives cease to matter. And unfortunately, that's going to be what happens. Now that the pandemic is pretty much over, at least according to Fauci, a lot of people are going to be left for dead by corporate America. Even after all that we have done to try and carry the economy on our backs through this. And I haven't had any fucking vacation throughout this entire thing, except for at the beginning of it when I took 2 weeks off because everyone else was. And I guess I'm ending it with one, although I don't think of vacation as being worried about my future the entire time. Without getting my side of the story, the DOL places their trust in the company that fired me, telling them that I just didn't show up like I knew I was supposed to, like it's some abusive ex-relationship or something, which jobs like Walmart are good at simulating. In addition to them already being a feudal system simulator where corporate are the nobility, supervisors are the clergy, and the low-level employees being what they already are in real life, the commoners. Like, we need to be reminded of how shitty our lives are. But yeah, Walmart fucks us over, changes shit without telling us, fires us for not adhering to said changes, and then lies to the DOL that we did know so they can avoid paying unemployment insurance. And in doing so, they look like any toxic SO anyone's ever had. Because that's what it is. Walmart is a toxic employer. I would eventually call the Office of Appeals halfway through the month just to see if my appeal was even active, and I was told that the appeal was on file and waiting to be reviewed. I was given a number to call and get a status update on my appeal, and the fuckers were still processing appeals from fucking November. That's a whole ass 6 months that you guys are behind on. There's no excuse for that. But anyway, I was told to call back in a month, and that just happened a week and a half ago as of recording this. And hold time, you want to know what the average fucking hold time was? 1 hour and 38 minutes to 2 hours and 20 minutes. I might as well just fucking drive to Topeka. What the fuck? You people seem to think that because we don't have a job to be at or money to go buy groceries with, that not only is there no rush to be answer calls from people that are just trying to get a status update on their appeal that'll take you 2 fucking minutes to give them, but you actively ignore their cry for help. My cry for help has been ignored for 4 months. So I decided to just hang up and maybe look on the website to see if there was a status update for my appeal on the benefits website. And when I looked at claim status, it said that there was no record of an active claim. So what did I do? I reapplied, because fuck it. You can't just fucking deny people benefits after they were fired without getting the employee's side of the story, because for all you know, this worker was overworked, abused verbally, and illegally terminated, only for the employer to tell you that the employee just wasn't showing up for work. But if I have to fight tooth and nail to win my case for benefits, that's exactly what the fuck I'm gonna do. I might lose anyway, in fact I kind of expect it to happen, but in that case, in the case that the DOL doesn't give a shit about me and the way Walmart fucked me over, I still have food benefits to fall back on, which I do already have by the way. There might be disability, which I guess people who deal with anxiety disorders and shit like me can apply for. And because I'm part Native American, I can also apply for financial compensation on that. June 1st update, it's now been over 2 weeks since I reapplied for unemployment benefits and no response. No development on the appeal for my first application either. So I guess this means I'm back to square one. I've been left for dead by the state of Kansas despite 2 years of hard work, 2 years without vacation, 2 years of narrowly avoiding this lethal disease, only to be left for dead because Walmart Almighty has forsaken me, using their indirect corporatist rule over this country to force me and thousands, potentially millions of other people that they have fired into poverty. Sickening. This reminds me of the first time I thought of the horrors of communism as being a projection made by the capitalist propaganda machine. I think what we should do, because boomers like to criticize young socialists saying we should send them to Cuba or Vietnam for a month and watch them come home with a newfound appreciation for liberal democracy, I think we should send the boomers, since they think capitalism is so ineffable as an economic system, and have them live in a socialist nation for a month before they should be able to make the judgment on whether or not communism is the same thing as fascism, or whether or not communism is a system that starves its citizens. Also, I applied for Sonic again on the 27th, so make that the fourth time that I applied for Sonic to be their cook, and still haven't heard anything back. But I also applied for not Dairy Queen, but basically our version of Dairy Queen, that I won't give out the name because I don't want my location narrowed down. But it's for a place out of town, $10 an hour. I guess we'll see how that develops. I know I said I've sworn off retail and that food service is kind of stretching what non-retail is, but I'm just trying to fucking be a cook. I don't care what my bosses think. If they think my cooking sucks, they can come and critique me on it. I also applied for Arby's in a place called Freddy's Frozen Custard and Steak Burgers, burger joint. So I've applied for four jobs. So far, I've only heard back from Freddy's. I applied for one of their restaurants in Oklahoma, but for some fucking reason, they sent my application to fucking Kansas City. Nice going, Freddy's. You were only 200 miles off, or an entire 3.5 hour drive, but you fucking nailed it. On the case of Kansas in particular being incompetent and also very stingy with their government assistance programs, I had a family member who I mentioned they had surgery in November. And because they were working in Oklahoma, they had to apply for unemployment benefits through Oklahoma. For context, they were working at Amazon. And you don't need me to tell you that Amazon is a shitty employer. I don't care how much they pay, I'll never work for Amazon. But my family member has actually had multiple surgeries because Amazon makes people do inhumane levels of work at inhumane intensity. With this recent surgery, Amazon was trying to put them on the active roster before they were even cleared to work. I should also mention that the Amazon was not paying my family member for being disabled during this time. And even when my family member was cleared, they didn't want to go back because they were afraid that they were going to fuck up their body again. And they'd have to have another surgery or even have a part of their body replaced or removed, or whatever have you. So they called HR and told them that they weren't going back unless some accommodations were made. Accommodations were never made, my family member was never contacted by HR or Amazon again, and they haven't worked since. But they decided to apply for unemployment, and they had to do so through Oklahoma. It wasn't a month-long wait for an interview, they were able to have the interview, and soon after, they got a letter that told them they won their case for unemployment benefits. They get a whole bunch of back pay, and this is kind of what we're hinging on. My family member is now being paid more than what they were earning at Amazon, between food benefits and unemployment. But because I worked in Kansas, I have to apply through Kansas. I was told that if I could get unemployment benefits, I'd be getting somewhere in the neighborhood of $250 a week, which is good. It's actually more than what I was making a week at my deli job. At my deli job, I was making around $175 a week. It kind of exposes just how little minimum wage workers are being paid. People on unemployment are being paid more than minimum wage workers. Why is that? The minimum wage should not be like a supplementary income that teenagers that work on the weekends or after school make, or retired elderly people who are just trying to find something to do. Grown-ass people, people in their 50s that have been working forever, work these jobs when there's nothing else besides food service or retail. Unemployment benefits should be the bare minimum of money that you need to keep fed and clean. The minimum wage needs to be a wage that you can actually start saving up and living comfortably. And sadly, not even $15 an hour makes that cut anymore. As I've had times where I couldn't pay rent or my phone bill without dipping into a negative balance while working at Walmart, making $14.50 an hour. I lived and still do live on a diet of fast food and frozen burritos. I try living cheap, but it just doesn't fucking work. Hearts of Iron 4 is the only luxury item that I bought while working at Walmart, just so I could have some fun and not be bored after a long night of stocking and zoning, the most tedious fucking work out there. I was fired on $700. Now that said, I still received my last paycheck, but I made it this far, and now I have nothing. I might even have a negative balance by the time this gets released. I'm in debt, and it's not like doing what I can to just not spend any money has helped, as my phone bill and car insurance have taken... Jesus motherfucking Christ, shut up! Oh yeah, did I mention that the railroads run this city? The government of this city whores themselves out for them. It's a dictatorship of the bourgeoisie. And see, if I were just able to fucking move out, I wouldn't have to fucking record in my car. I could just have my own space in my own house, and I wouldn't have to worry about outside noise and people hearing me. As my phone bill and my car insurance have taken the brunt of what I have left. And now that I can't pay my bills because the DOL likes to play with people's fates, I owe $160 on my phone bill, I owe $55 to pay off my car insurance, which was cancelled, and I have to pay $66 to get my car tags renewed. That's almost $300 that I owe. So even if I do get unemployment benefits, it'll take 2 weeks now to get everything paid. So $250 I could be earning a week if I get unemployment benefits, but it's probably going to take 250 more days to finally have something figured out. My phone service had also been suspended for a short time, which may be why I haven't heard anything. So how am I supposed to be able to get a job if I don't have a phone and I can't take calls or texts and be able to pay my bills? You see how that works, phone companies? Thanks for robbing me of every last cent I have and still being hungry for more. But my mother stepped in and helped me out. Fucking embarrassing, this is what I have to do. I have to take handouts from my mother because job prospects are practically non-existent, and all the government sees in the working class are a bunch of dollar signs, and they don't want to support the people that have lost their jobs. Meanwhile, with how stingy Kansas is with benefits, my grandmother applied for food benefits, and guess how much she'll be making a month? She's retired, lives alone, and has never made that much money, but all she will be receiving is $37 a month on food benefits. $37. That's $1.23 per day. That's also the same cost as 7 Marie Callender beef pot pies. 7! How the fuck is she supposed to eat 3 meals a day when she can only afford 7 pot pies across the span of 30 fucking days? At the same time though, she's diabetic, and I'm not sure if pot pies are diabetic friendly. But what she can eat are those mega meals, and those are $3.31 a piece for the boneless fried chicken, and with $37 a month, she can get 10 of those. I resent the state of Kansas. I've already been regretting moving back here from Oregon back in 2018, but this is the final straw. The only thing I saw in moving back to Kansas was finishing high school virtually, whereas I could not in Oregon. I really should have looked towards the future and asked about what kind of job opportunities there are, and if I'd be able to sustain myself and eventually move out. But I guess how can you gauge a global pandemic, economic crash, skyrocketing gas prices, and inflation 2 years before shit hits the fan? But moving back here is one of the biggest regrets I have up to this point in my life. And that beats being an asshole back in the day. I used to be a major dickhead. I used to be an asshole to my little brother. I used to not love my cats. I used to yell at them and spank them when they pissed me off. I realized the error of those ways right before the news broke that Steve Cash killed himself. And maybe this is my karma. I don't know. I'm in one of the darkest places I've ever been in thanks to the conditions of my life situation. The depression, the resentment, it's unlike anything I've ever felt. My mind is racing, I feel like this is how I'm gonna die, and that the Holocaust against the American peasantry is getting ready to shift into high gear. People are losing their jobs, prices are rising all over, and the state minimum wage hasn't risen by so much as a cent in 14 years. And the government is giving out pathetically low benefits, all while the economy is continuing to rise, and the top richest people have increased their wealth by tens of billions, hundreds of billions, since the start of the pandemic. Fuck you, Kansas. Seriously, fuck you. Your benefits are shit, your jobs are shit, your infrastructure is shit, your government is shit, you're just a fucking joke. $192 billion state GDP, 2 million people, and a poverty rate of 11.4% versus Algeria. Algeria's $193 billion GDP, 44 million people, and 4.5% poverty rate. What's your excuse? You'd expect somewhere like Algeria to be impoverished, war-torn, and worse off. But it's doing better than the state of Kansas. I'm sorry, but as soon as I have the money, I'm moving the fuck back to Oregon. My life right now would undoubtedly be far better. I know the cost of living is higher in Oregon, but I have a feeling that it's at least balanced out with increased job opportunities, the minimum wage is higher, maybe the DOL will at least give a shit if I lose my job. Infrastructure is better, the air is cleaner, I remember the 4 years I lived there, the small town I lived in there, the smaller town than what I live in now. Built a new school and a hospital. What have we added here in Kansas in the past 4 years I've been back? A coffee shop? For every 3 businesses that have closed down, 1 new thing has been added. Nothing of significance has been added since I first left this place almost 9 years ago. The GDP of Kansas is doing just fine, but the state can't be bothered to fund the public sector. They can't be bothered to fund new projects. They can't be bothered to bring in new businesses. And when people start losing their jobs and they can't find a job elsewhere, our politicians start pointing their wretched fingers at immigrants, blaming them for the problems of the working class. And unfortunately, the people here eat that propaganda up with a spoon. But I'm not that stupid. If a country like Algeria is doing just fine. Immigrants aren't what's wrong with Kansas, it's the government.
Last minute update, the second application for unemployment benefits was just thrown out. No letter back telling me anything, no chance for recourse. I've exhausted every job opportunity at my disposal. The only opportunities that truly remain are the retail jobs where I know I'm just gonna go back to being treated like shit and paid jack shit, or the truck driver jobs that I'm not even qualified for, but even if I was, I'd much rather not be responsible for driving around cattle, freight, trailer houses, cars, equipment, and God knows what else on busy roads. I already have enough anxiety driving on the main road in my civilian car, so I'm about as close to rock bottom as I can get. It feels like I'm going back to the days before I started working. I can't buy my own food. I'm needing people to be responsible for my own bills. Car insurance is something that I shouldn't even be concerning myself with, and it truly sucks. At some point, I'm gonna have people fucking telling me to grow up. But at least now I can just use the excuse of, look, motherfucker, I lost my job, and I lost it because the assholes I was working for made it exceedingly inconvenient for me, and I haven't been able to get on financial assistance because the government is greedy as fuck. That's just the truth. I know I said that I would like to move to Oregon as soon as I have the money, but the longer I sit here waiting for something to happen, the more I start to think that I'm fucking trapped here. Unless I want to brave the 2-month walking journey that it would take, then I'm as good as superglue to this town. But I did reapply for benefits once again, but I guess since the DOL obviously doesn't give a shit about the working class, all I can really hope for is that I'm eligible for disability, or that one of the businesses I applied for eventually gets back to me and tells me, hey, we would be happy to have you working for us. When are you available for an interview? But in the meantime, all I can do is take advice from people on the web that have been through the same horse shit. And in doing so these past couple days, I'm now hoping I can win some money doing sweepstakes, play-to-wins, that sort of thing. I know I'm probably doing the same exact thing as millions of other people in this situation, but all I can do is try. I'm sure I'm probably not the first person at rock bottom placing their last bit of faith in this that would go on to win a jackpot. At the same time, though, who's to say that I won't hit a paywall when I try to claim the prize money? It's no wonder that people turn to gambling when their means of financial security could just fuck off anytime, any day. But you know, despite everything, I'm still glad that I got fired, because the people that work at my Walmart are a bunch of fucking idiots that place their trust in and worship the bourgeoisie and take the side of the elite. They place the blame for their situation on communism when it couldn't be clearer that it's capitalism that causes their struggle, to pay the bills and feed the family. The propaganda machine truly does project the suffering it causes to the so-called suffering endured by workers under communist regimes. It's called complacency, and Lord knows that I would rather be homeless than under the thumb of a clique of supervisors that act as though they are the jocks and treat the associates as though they are the nerds. Only a fool wouldn't question tyrant bosses existing under so-called democracy, and only a fool wouldn't begin to associate said tyrant bosses with what they have been led to believe life under communism would be like.
And that's where I'm going to leave things. If you like this video, please be sure to click thumbs up, share the video far and wide, leave your thoughts. Are you in Kansas? Have you had the same nightmare as me? Regardless of if you live in the state, are you in the same boat as me where the DOL is just being shitty about benefits, yet you can't find a job? Leave your experience in the comments below. And if you liked what you saw, please consider subscribing. I forgot to mention that at 1,000 subscribers, I'll also be starting a Patreon in addition to reacting to Everywhere at the End of Time. So when I do that, each and every donation will be appreciated, and once I'm at the point with donations that I can start living comfortably, I'll start giving back to the people. Also, please click the bell if you'd like to get notified when I next release a video, and I'll see you guys soon for another video. Bye, guys.